protected by the good lore and a gun. And you might meet them both if you show up here not welcome, son. Our necks are burnt, our roads are dirt, and our trucks ain't clean. The dogs run loose, we smoke, we chew, and fry everything out here. Way out here.
This is my newest edition. It's a Sega 223. It comes with this 10-round magazine. And no sling, I made the sling and put it on there. This is going to be my oh shit brush gun. I've taken the butt stock cap off and the little pistol grip hole down here cap off, and I'm about to show you what I put in there. But I got it offline for, after everything's said and done, $395. I'm getting an adapter that'll put in the magazine well, so it'll hold M16 mags, so I can just switch between that and my AR. And all done and said, $500 for a 223 compatible rifle. Not too shabby. Yeah, this is still a Sega. Made in Russia. Alright. Roll this over here. I've got a little flint striker shoved down this hole here. I got a wedge in there pretty good so it doesn't rattle. Over in this side, over here, move this around a bit so the glare ain't getting you. I've got mini first aid kit stuff in here, a little 89 cent poncho and a emergency blanket, a filtration straw that's good for 20 gallons, and some odds and ends, a little bitty cleaning kit, and another lighter. So. Just basic survival crap. And then that's all shoved in there. I'll put the butt stock back or butt cap back on, and then this cap here back on. And there's my Sega. I wove this for the sling. It's 14 yards of cordage over 2 yards of this ratchet strap type of material here. Alright, this is going further into my Sega 223 review. It's an AK-47 manufacturer style. It's got the big flap safety, which I don't really like that much, but it's an AK. I mean, you know what you're getting when you get it. Here's the magazine release is here. It's a pain in the butt. And you gotta rock in your magazines and then click them in and lock them in. Now when I get my adapter, hopefully that'll be alleviated there. To take it apart, you have to push this button right here down. Pops off this top rail here, and then your spring and your chamber or whatever pop out. It's not too bad a rifle. I like the trigger pull and the let off on it. It's not too bad for being fresh out the box. I'm videotaping this just holding the camcorder, so this looks kind of crappy. My bad. It came with the butt stock empty and hollow, which is fine on a 223, but Sega also makes 12 gauge, 20 gauge, 7.62, and any of them, I would recommend putting some sort of counterweight in the butt to lessen the recoil. I mean, a hollow butt stock on a 12 gauge is going to feel like somebody punching you every time you pull the trigger. It's going to suck. We'll get back more into that later. I sighted it in. This is 25 yards. I got it sighted into that right there. It's 4 shots. Kind of keyhole that one there. Not bad at all. I had it in a sled though, so this is all just sights. This is not my ability really that much at all. It's all in the sled. Here's the 100 yards. This is not in a sled. I'm shooting about an inch high, maybe an inch and a half high, which is what you want at 100 yards. You should have, for a 223, you should want to try to keep it in within 4 inches. So at 25 yards, I was hitting a little low. This is without any, this is just iron sights though, so I could have been aiming up here and hitting an inch low, which it should be at 25 yards, probably inch and a half low, I think. And then at 100 yards, you should be an inch to inch and a half, I think, high. And then back down at like 300 yards, you're an inch and a half low again, I think. Don't quote me on that, but that's the general idea, I think. I'm not really sure. Right over there. Just like an AK-47, the rear sight does not move. I mean, you got this flapper long range thing, Bill Bopper, they put on here. You can kick it up and Matthew Quigley somebody, I guess. But you can't adjust the sight. All your sight adjustments are done in the front. And sorry, I'm gonna try to. This is gonna get crazy for a second. All right, let's try that. All right. Now I own an AK-47, so I have one of these little adjuster tools. The weapon did not come with this. You need to go out and buy one of these before you get your Sega so that you can adjust your sight. You flip this over, and this has got a little hole in the middle, and it fits down over your front sight, and then you can turn it one way or the other to adjust whatever. Now, that gives you your up and down. To get your windage, this clamps over this way, and then this screws in. You'll screw this in like this, and that'll push your front sight left or right. Your front sight slides on this rod here, one way or the other, just like a standard AK sight, front sight. If I wouldn't have had this little tool here, I wouldn't have been able to sight it in, because it was a pain in the butt to try to manipulate one of these front sights without this special tool. So make sure you have one of these before you get an AK or your Sega 223. Beyond that, it's a good looking gun. It's got a good weight to it. I like it a lot for the money. You can't beat it. Like I said, for basically $500, that's with the adapter and stuff in the magazine well, you can have a 223 AR equivalent almost. I mean, it's an AK style weapon. You're not going to get, you know, beautiful sniper rifle action out of it without doing a lot of work to them. But just out of the box, you saw how it was shooting. It's not too shabby at all. I'm pretty impressed with it. For the equivalent AR, you'd have to pay $8,000 or $9,000, something like that. $800 or $900, maybe $1,000. I don't know. But yeah, this is my Sega 223. Let me know what you think. All right, take this apart for maintenance and stuff. You just push this button in. Pain in the butt. Lift up on this back part here. That'll pop off. You'll push this in out of its catch and take the spring out, and then making sure the trigger's down, you'll bring out the back of the chamber around the gas plug and stuff. And it's dirty. I just shot it today. I need to clean it. But that's it. Three pieces and it's apart. There you go. Alright, to put it back together, you just put this in the top hole, push it in. These will line up in little slots. Push it down, and then you push it all the way forward. Put your spring right here in this hole, push it all the way forward, and let it push itself back into these rails right here. And you put this C-shape into this C-shape over here. Hold it forward, make sure it's lined up, and then smack it real good. And it's back together. There you go, Sega 223.